teams. So what we have learned so far, we know that spot rate is simply a discount rate that you are actually earning on a zero coupon bond. But we have a coupon bond here. Let us say a coupon bond with coupon of 10%, maturity of 3 years, face value 1000, and we have been provided with different spot rates. So spot rate for year 1 is 8%. I'm intentionally going to keep a big difference between them. Unrealistic scenario, but more for understanding purpose. Spot rate of 2, year 2 is 14%, and year 3 is 20%. Can you value this bond now using 3 spot rates? Yes. First year cash flow discount with first year spot rate, second year cash flow with second year spot rate, third year with third year spot rate. Quickly find out value. And also have those memory slots intact. We are going to use them later on. So how do you value this bond? Your cash flows are 100, 100 and 1100. The first year spot rate is 8%. So first cash flow is discounted with 8%. Second cash flow is to be discounted with 14. And the third cash flow is discounted with 20%. Let's solve it together for those of you who did not get the answer. 100 divided by 1.08 equal to STO1. 100 divided by 1.08 equal to STO1. 100 divided by 1.14x square equal to STO2. 1.2 varus 2x 3 equal to 1 by x multiplied with 1100 equal to STO 3. RCL 1 plus RCL 2 plus RCL 3, and that would come out to be 806.11. Are we together here? Nakul? Now say this. If I tell you now, if these rates are not available, but what we know is that price of the bond is 806.11. These are the cash flows. Can you calculate a YTM on the bond? Yes, because you want to know how much I have earned. So how will you calculate a YTM? Second clear TVM, 806.11 negative. Make it negative and then say present value. 100 payment, 1000 future value, 3 is N, compute IY. 19.07. So YTM of these numbers is 07. Okay, so what is the meaning of 19.07? Instead of using three different rates, if I say 1 plus 19.07% raised to 1, 1 plus 19.07% raised to 2, 1 plus 19.07% raised to 3. Even in that case, the equation is satisfied. So what does it mean? It means that YTM is some sort of a complex mathematical average, and I'm going to repeat this again. YTM is some sort of a complex mathematical average of various spot rates. So that 19.07 is calculated in such a way, and your calculator is doing it using trial and error, that instead of using these three separate numbers, that one single 19.07 will fit in. And YTM will always be closer to the spot rate of last maturity, because the biggest cash flow out of these is the last cash flow. And therefore you would say that YTM would be closest to the spot rate of the last maturity. Making sense? Write down then.